that better?
And then I don't need the slides too.
So since the last override for Ash West had passed in 2005, and the most recent cuts for FY16 were over $1 million for our district. So at that point, when SOX formed, we had just had 17 full-time equivalent layoffs, including 12 classroom teachers, paraprofessionals, reduction in sports teams, extracurricular activities, supplies, the whole gamut. And we formed sort of over our frustration with parents and community members to these cuts to try to see what we could do to make a difference in terms of funding for our schools and restoration of what had been lost over the years. Those cuts had resulted in elementary class sizes of upwards of 30. We have no certified librarians in the district anymore. We have block schedule at the high school, so students were unable to have full course schedules. We were no longer enough sections to offer sections for all of our high school students throughout the year. We have uncapped user fees of $285 per student per activity, which, believe me as a parent, adds up really quickly. We're up over $1,100 this year for our family alone. SOX, we started by extending open invitations to anyone in either community interested in meeting to discuss these issues and sort of brainstorming sessions. We would meet with anybody willing to talk to us. Our superintendent was very supportive, our school committee. We've met with former board of selectmen, our state reps, town administrators. If you were willing to sit down and talk to us, we wanted to hear. And what we learned, we tried to get out into the communities just to spread the word what was going on and get that community education piece in place. Eventually, we decided to advocate on behalf of an override for the district in support of the superintendent's prioritized budget, which is a 5-year strategic plan for our district. We spent most of January through August of last year doing that, and it was a long process. Ultimately, it passed by one vote in Ashburnham, as I came up before. So never think that your vote doesn't count. Most of what we did was just trying to encourage people to show up to meetings, town meetings, to get it to a ballot, show up in August for the second vote in the middle of vacation season, to get that passed. Since then, we never intended to be just an override group. Throughout that process, we were advocating at the state level as well, collecting signatures to support various bills, writing to our representatives and senators, meeting with our representatives. We stay informed, and we pass that word out through our email group, as well as on Facebook. And we're working to connect with other advocacy groups across the region to hopefully have a louder voice and implement broader changes. And at this point, we are collaborating with IMSU on transportation funding.
So I Am Wachusett started as a Facebook page in 2016 by two sisters who lived in the district. It was frustration after another failed budget. We have to have 4 out of 5 towns vote yes. There is always one that votes no. And there's another one with a very high tax rate that may or may not vote no. They were also frustrated that at the time we had the lowest per pupil spending of any regional school district, even though we were the largest at a little over 7,000 students. We already lost or never had elementary and middle school librarians, free full-day kindergarten, late buses, up-to-date technology and textbooks, AP offerings, guidance counselors at the elementary level. At the time, we had no deputy superintendent for a regional school district of 7,000 students, and we had a very lean administration. So in the summer of 2017, there was a call to action by a school committee member to bring the advocacy off of social media. So I answered the call, and with her, created a flyer, and we were given space to meet at the district offices. We met in September of 2017. About 40 people attended. The superintendent came, school committee members, some selectmen, lots of parents, and lots of teachers. We basically just had a brainstorming session. session. And what really came out of it was that there was three basic issues. Basically, we had a revenue problem, lots of that from the state, lots of that from all other complicated things that we just heard about today. We realized the district also had a publicity problem. There was a lot of us versus them. It's the school district against the fire department. It's the school district against all the towns. And there was also this ridiculous assumption that we had a bloated administration, which just was absolutely crazy. And we also realized in that meeting that a lot of citizens didn't realize how their local government worked. They didn't know you could go to town meeting. They didn't know you had a right to vote, which I think is just an awesome thing about living in Massachusetts. So we decided to stay a simple grassroots movement as opposed to becoming a political action committee, which I think Steve would have liked us to do, or a nonprofit. So this is our simple mission statement, just basically to promote communication and support the school budget. We decided to focus on one very easy to understand issue, just so that we could get the word out there about who we were. We based it off of Auditor Bunce's report, so we decided to go for the 100% regional school district transportation reimbursement. We decided on this because we really wanted to try to unite the five towns as opposed to fighting with each other. So we decided to give them a common enemy of the state, so we could all fight the state together. We created an online petition on change.org. We started a letter writing campaign. And we tried to do lots of community outreach to get people familiar with our group and this issue. So we wanted to be accessible off of social media, so we set up a website, and a lot of it was actually modeled on SOC's website. We wanted to make all of the actions that we wanted people to take easy and accessible. So we had links to legislators' emails, we had their full addresses, we had form letters for people to fill out so that it was just an easy, quick, 5-minute thing. And we also had a link to the petition. We targeted just a few people at first, the chairs of Ways and Means, chairs of Education Committee, and the governor and Karen Pulido at first. So to reach the community, we kind of went out, we got tables at craft fairs, we went to the Rutland Festival of Trees and made a Christmas tree with school buses and money on it to kind of explain the situation. And we also created a pamphlet that people could take that explained who we were, what the issue was, and it had all the actions on it. And I have a few copies of that if anybody wants one after. We currently have about 3,000 signatures on the online petition, which I print out occasionally and send out to those on the list. So now we're trying to move on to our local focus. We want to educate people about the district, kind of what we should have, what does a similar district to our district have, and then what do we actually have. We also try to fill seats at school committee and town meetings. We're trying. Sometimes there's two of us, but we're also trying to educate people about annual town meeting. We want to make up a flyer, have tables at more events, and present to different groups to kind of give all that information out there. And we also want to get people communicating with their local officials. We've realized that when citizens are in the room, it really changes the temperature in the room. We had all the five towns get together in the fall and discuss everything, the budget with the school committee, and apparently it's a pretty contentious, it can be a pretty contentious meeting usually, but we had about 40 people show up to the audience, and it was very positive, and they all agreed on doing a letter campaign about regional school district transportation, and so it was kind of interesting to see that. So now, this is kind of like a snowball rolling down a hill in the 6 months it started. So a Triton school committee member has now started a Facebook page, Support Mass Regional Schools, and it's got 400 members and growing since it started last week. It's just on Facebook for now, but most likely it will, all of the information will also be housed on our iamwachusett.org website. I think there's lots of people from all different districts all over, so we're just trying to have a coordinated effort. It's growing, but it's hard to figure out how to make it grow and successfully grow. These are different ways that you can reach out to the different groups. Please reach out to us. All of the women I work with were more than willing. We're very passionate about this. So send any active community members our way. I sent email to all the superintendents of the academic districts. So we're ready to work. So just trying to help. Any questions?
Great job. I know a contiguous member of regional that got your letters. Bob and Gretchen deserve to have to try to work together on some things. And I really appreciate what you've done. You certainly have initiated some work in our district at the grassroots level, which is so important. And I think a couple of years ago, you guys were doing something, iamwachusett, and it was really powerful. iamwachusett, and we have no textbooks in the high school that aren't, like 10 years old.
That's how it started. It was pictures of kids with a sign that said, I am the librarian in my elementary school, iamwachusett. That's how, and it grew. I think she has 1,500 people still on that page, and she continues to disseminate information. And that is one of the things we were trying to figure out how to.
Congratulations.
Yes. Yeah. Thank you.